I am Rianne Engels. I'm working at the Radboud University Medical Center in Nijmegen, the Netherlands. I'm going to tell you something about the most optimal MP MRI of the prostate. Prostate cancer is the most common non-cutaneous cancer in men in the world. 1 in 6 men will be affected during his life. With MRI, a clinical suspicion of prostate cancer can be detected accurately, localized, as well as determine the aggressiveness and possible metastatic spread of the disease. Indications to perform an MP MRI of the prostates are an increased PSA value, an abnormal digital rectal exam, or a positive family history of prostate cancer. A proper patient preparation is very important to achieve a good quality MP MRI of the prostate. The following preparations are used. No dietary restrictions. Refrain from ejaculation 3 days prior to the MR examination to better evaluate the seminal vesicles. An empty bowel and bladder before the MR to prevent movement artifacts. An injection of scopolamide butyl for the reduction of bowel movement. And removing air in the rectum with a catheter to prevent distortion artifacts. This image shows an MP MRI of the prostate with and without prior use of a rectum catheter to remove air from the rectum. The images in the upper row were made without the use of a rectum catheter, whereas the images in the lower row were made after the use of a rectum catheter. Especially the diffusion-weighted imaging can show distortion without prior use of a rectum catheter. After the use of a rectum catheter, the distortion disappears. For MP MRI of the prostate, the use of a 3 Tesla MRI compared to a 1.5 Tesla MRI is preferred due to the increased signal-to-noise ratio, especially for diffusion-weighted imaging. In case of a patient with an MR conditional pacemaker, a 1.5 Tesla MRI can be used for MP MRI of the prostate. The coils that are used for MP MRI of the prostate are a spine coil and a pelvic body phased array coil. There's no need to use an endorectal coil anymore. Before starting the examination, air from the rectum is removed with a rectum catheter. And a contrast injector is installed. The protocol for MP MRI of the prostate consists of T2 weighted imaging in 3 planes, diffusion weighted imaging, and dynamic contrast enhanced imaging in the axial plane. The T2-weighted imaging shows the anatomy of the prostate. With the diffusion-weighted imaging, lesions can be characterized, and the dynamic contrast-enhanced imaging shows the vascularity of the prostate tissue. After removing rectal air, the patient is positioned feet first supine on the MRI table with a body-phased array coil on the pelvis. Scopolamine butyl is injected and the contrast injector is installed. The patient is slid into the MRI until his pelvis is in the middle of the magnet. First, some short images are made to localize the prostate and to make sure the prostate is positioned in the center of the magnetic field. Then the T2 sagittal image is placed on the center of the prostate. Make sure the complete prostate and the caudal 2/3 of the seminal vesicles are in the scan box. Angulation is not necessary. The T2 coronal image is placed parallel to the back wall of the prostate. With correct angulation, the prostate shows as a heart shape. This way, possible tumor extension from the peripheral zone to the seminal vesicles will be visible. It's important to look at the settings of the angulation for the position of the axial image. Make sure the complete prostate and seminal vesicles are in the scan box. The T2 axial image is placed perpendicular on the coronal image. The settings of the coronal angulation can be used to set the angle for the axial image. Simply enter the same angle but in a negative number. Make sure the complete prostate is in the scan box with a minimum 2/3 of the seminal vesicles. To decrease distortion artifacts and mismatch between the T2 axial and the diffusion weighted image, the green shimming box is positioned as a small box around the prostate. Also, it is important to use a left to right phase encoding direction to prevent motion artifacts across of the prostate. The diffusion weighted image is scanned in the axial plane with the same number of slices, slice thickness and phase encoding direction as the T2 axial image. The position of the diffusion weighted image can be copied from the T2 axial image. Make sure the shim box is also copied with copy adjust volume. The diffusion image is consists of multiple B values, B50, 400, 800, and a calculated 1400 with an ADC map. The dynamic contrast-enhanced image is also in an axial plane with the same slice thickness and phase encoding direction as the T2 axial image. The position of the image can be copied from the T2 axial plane. The DCE consists of multiple measurements. After the first measurement, the contrast is injected. A good image quality is essential for an accurate diagnosis. One of the most important factors is the signal-to-noise ratio. With an increased signal-to-noise ratio, more detailed images can be made. Another important factor that influences image quality are artifacts. The most common artifacts in MP-MRI of the prostate are motion-related, coil-related, or patient-related. This image shows an example of a good quality T2-weighted axial image on the left and a T2-weighted axial image influenced by motion artifacts on the right. The image on the right is blurry and details cannot be shown. It's very important to recognize these kind of artifacts because they make it more difficult to get an accurate diagnosis. This image shows an example of coil-related artifacts caused by an anorectal coil. Arrow 1 shows the straight line artifact as a black line through the seminal vesicles. Arrow 2 shows the ghosting artifact, in which you see the repeated structure of the rectum from left to right in the image. Arrow 3 shows the coil flare artifact, where you can see an increased signal intensity in the peripheral zone caused by the high intensity of the anorectal coil. All these artifacts influence the image quality. This image shows an example of a patient with a hip prosthesis that causes artifacts in the image. Especially the diffusion-weighted image on the right have limited diagnostic value. In case of a hip prosthesis, special image techniques can be used to decrease the artifacts, or the patient can be scanned on a lower strength magnetic field. Optimal multiparametric MR imaging of the prostate is dependent on the used equipment, patient preparation, absence or reduction of artifacts, and MRI technologist's experience. A high-quality prostate MP-MRI can only be achieved when all these factors are met. Thank you for watching. When you want to know more about prostate MRI, you can watch the other videos about prostate reporting and MR-guided biopsy and transfusion biopsy.